Hello students, today we will discuss about nutritional requirements of bacteria. We all know that in diagnostic labs of microbiology, we need to cultivate the bacteria or isolate the bacteria from the clinical samples, and for that we need culture media. And in order to design a culture media or to prepare a culture media, we should always know what are the nutritional requirements of bacteria. Based on the different nutritional requirement only, we can select the media, and then only the desired pathogen will grow. So for bacteria, the minimum requirement that is needed for its growth are water, source of carbon, source of nitrogen, and inorganic salts. So these are the basic requirements, and apart from this, certain organisms need blood or serum for their extra nutrition. So nitrogen is required for the synthesis of DNA, RNA, or ATP. Sulfur is required for certain amino acids, vitamins, etc. And then inorganic salts is required to facilitate enzymatic catalysis and maintain chemical gradient across the cell membrane. So every component, water, carbon, nitrogen, and everything, all these have their own importance in bacterial culture and media. Apart from these ingredients, there are certain other factors also which we'll be discussing, certain physical factors like temperature and pH, which are very important for growing the bacteria. Now, in the next slide, we will first discuss non-fastidious and fastidious bacteria. This is very important. If we are talking about nutritional requirement of bacteria, this is the classification of bacteria based on their nutritional requirement. So, there are two categories, fastidious and non-fastidious. First, we will talk about non-fastidious. So, non-fastidious are the organisms that can grow in basic culture media. Basic culture media are the media which has very simple on the minimum composition or ingredients that are required for the growth. For example, here in this diagram, you can see in this picture, this is nutrient agar, and I have Escherichia coli growing on this nutrient agar. So Escherichia coli is a non-fastidious organism. That is why it is able to grow on simple media, nutrient agar. In this picture, however, let me first tell you what fastidious bacteria are. So fastidious bacteria means these bacteria do not grow on simple medium, or even if they are growing, they don't express all its character, or the colonies are not well grown on the simple medium. So they need enriched media. Enriched medium means these medias have extra source of nutrition. Now if you come to this picture here, this is a blood agar. And this is an enriched medium, so it has blood. Blood is giving the extra source of nutrition. So as you see, actually these colonies are pneumococcus. So pneumococcus, streptococcus pneumonia or pneumococcus are fastidious organism, and you can see how well it is growing on blood agar. If you try to grow them on nutrient agar, you will not see any growth, because they need they are fastidious and they need blood or any other source of nutrient. So this is about fastidious and non-fastidious organism. Now coming to the nutritional requirements, so we will discuss them one by one. First is oxygen. So oxygen is a very important factor, and based on the oxygen requirement, the organisms are classified as obligate aerobes, obligate anaerobes, facultative aerobes, microaerophilic bacteria. Not all of them are listed here, but we will discuss about it. Obligate aerobes mean the, are the organisms which strictly need oxygen, which cannot survive in anything other than oxygen. They need oxygen, complete supply of oxygen. Facultative aerobes are actually anaerobic bacteria, but they need some amount of carbon dioxide for their some amount of carbon dioxide for better growth. So they are called facultative aerobes. Similarly, we have obligate anaerobes. Obligate anaerobes means they are strict anaerobes, and a little amount of oxygen can kill them. एंड फैकल्टेटिव एनारोब्स मीन्स आर एक्चुअली एरोबिक बैक्टीरिया बट लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन कैन सॉरी लिटिल अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड कैन फैसिलिटेट देयर ग्रोथ. जस्ट इग्नोर दिस एग्जाम्पल ई कोलाई ओवर हियर. देन माइक्रो एरोफिलिक बैक्टीरिया. माइक्रो एरोफिलिक बैक्टीरिया मीन्स दीज आर द बैक्टीरिया दैट ग्रोज इन अ वेरी लो सप्लाई ऑफ ऑक्सीजन. इफ द ऑक्सीजन सप्लाई इज एज लो एज 4% दे विल ग्रो. सो दे नीड वेरी लो ऑक्सीजन और लो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड ऑल्सो फॉर देयर ग्रोथ. नेक्स्ट इज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. सो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज ऑल्सो रिक्वायर्ड बाई बैक्टीरिया. सो the bacteria that grows better in the presence of high amount of carbon dioxide are called capnophilic bacteria. And one example is the Streptococcus pyogenes that will give you better colonies if you have it incubated in presence of 5-10% carbon dioxide. And examples are Haemophilus influenza, Brucella abortus. Then comes the physical factor that is very important, the temperature. Every bacteria has an optimum temperature at which it is pathogenic, at which it grows well in the lab. So for most of the pathogens of human, bacterial pathogens of human, the temperature, the optimum temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. And it's not that it is fixed for all the bacteria, it varies, and based on that we have classified bacteria. So we have saprophytes. Saprophytes are the bacteria that love cold environment. So they need lower temperature, like 0-20 degrees Celsius. And they are mostly the soil saprophytes or saprophytes that are found in water. Mesophytes are the bacteria that grow in the temperature range of 25 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius. And most pathogenic species of bacteria for human falls under this group, mesophiles. And then there are thermophiles, and these thermophiles are the bacteria that need very high temperature for their growth, like from 55-80 degrees Celsius is the range. So there are three categories based on temperature: saprophiles, cold loving bacteria, mesophiles 25-40 degrees Celsius, and thermophiles 55-80 degrees Celsius. Next important factor is pH. So pH of the medium is very important. If you are preparing a media and before autoclaving, if you have not checked the pH of the media and if you have not adjusted the pH of the media, then it is of no use, because if you don't check the pH, if pH is higher or lower than required, then the organism will never grow on it. For most pathogenic bacteria that cause infection of human being, the required pH falls under 7.2 to 7.6. But there are certain pathogens which grow at different pH range apart from this also. Lactobacilli, if you have heard about lactobacillus, they are the bacteria which love acidic pH, which can grow well in acidic pH of 4. And this is the reason why, you know, acid, when the pickles are formed and there is fermentation, so that is the reason the pickle are preserved from bacteria, because of the acid produced due to fermentation in the pickles, the organism, the bacteria cannot grow. If you take an example of Vibrio cholera also grows in a very alkaline environment. The pH range is 8.2 to 8.9. So it needs the media, all the media which are selective for Vibrio cholera has a very high alkalinity, and that is the reason it is selective and it does not allow to grow any other bacteria apart from Vibrio cholera. So this was about nutritional requirement of bacteria. And we shall summarize what we have discussed. So bacteria basically needs water, carbon source, and nitrogen, and inorganic salt. So these are the components that are supposed to be in the cultural media. And then there are physical factors like the temperature and the pH that must be optimum for the growth of the organism. There are two types of bacteria based on the nutritional requirements: fastidious and non-fastidious. Non-fastidious are the organisms that can easily be grown in any basic medium or simple medium. Fastidious, on the other hand, will not grow in basic medium or simple medium. Here you can see you have a Newton agar plate where Escherichia coli is growing, which is a non-fastidious organism. On the other hand, in this picture, you can see Pneumococcus, which is a fastidious organism growing on plat agar. Now coming to the nutritional requirements. So oxygen is one of the major requirement of bacteria, and based on their requirement or percentage of requirement, they can be divided into obligate aerobes, obligate anaerobes, facultative aerobes and facultative anaerobes, and microaerophilic bacteria that requires very low amount of oxygen as well as carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide loving bacteria are called capnophilic, which need more than the normal percentage of carbon dioxide. And then comes the temperature, very important. This is the temperature at which you incubate your culture plates. So there are three categories of bacteria based on the optimum temperature: 0 to 20 degrees Celsius, psychrophiles. Mesophiles are the organisms that grow well between 25 to 40 degrees Celsius of temperature, and this is the group which has most of the human pathogens. Then there are thermophiles, which are heat loving microbes, and they grow between 55 to 80 degrees Celsius of temperature. Next, very important is the pH. If the pH of the media is imbalanced, the organism will not grow into it. And the optimum pH for most of the pathogenic bacteria of human are is between 7.2 to 7.6. However, there are bacteria like Lactobacilli, which grows at very acidic pH of 4. And again, there are bacteria like Vibrio cholera that grows at a pH of 8.2 to 8.9. So pH must always be checked. If the pH is not coming between the expected range, then it must be adjusted using one normal hydrochloric acid or one normal sodium hydroxide. So thank you, that was about the nutritional requirement of bacteria. Hope you understood what are the basic requirements of bacteria, what are the things that must be present in a culture medium, what are fastidious and non-fastidious organism, what are the categories based on oxygen requirements, then temperature, and what are the optimum temperature and pH required for the growth of bacteria. Hope you have understood this topic, and please go through your textbook and read about this, and come back and post your doubts in the comment section. Thank you so much.